Hey everyone, my name is Wolverlida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect, and in this video, we're going to learn how we can use local large language models with Semantic Kernel. Now, in previous videos, I've used Azure OpenAI and OpenAI with Semantic Kernel, but those options require us to either have access to Azure OpenAI, which is currently restricted, or we can actually buy credits to use the OpenAI's API. But in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to explore two options that we can use to build Semantic Kernel applications using large language models that are hosted on our local machine. And the first option we'll look at is Ollama. Now, Ollama is a tool that allows us to run small and large language models on our local machine. So here I am, the Ollama landing page, and I can see I can run models such as Llama 3, Phi 3, Mistral, Gemma 2, or any other models that are available. If I click on models here, I can actually see all the models that are available to me through Ollama. Or I can even create my custom large language models and run them through Ollama as well, which is pretty cool. Now, to get started with Ollama, all we really need to do is actually download it from the website here, so we can use it for macOS, we can use it in Linux or Windows. I've gone ahead and done this, and what this allows us to do is we run a local web server that's running on localhost 11434, and we can actually interact with models through that web server through the Ollama CLI. So if I look at the GitHub page, excuse me, I can see that I can run models using Ollama run, and a whole bunch of different models and their sizes and how I can download them onto my local machine. I've gone ahead and downloaded Phi 3. So that's the model we're gonna be using in this tutorial. But we can create our own custom models, we can pull it down. It's very similar to how you kind of work with images in Docker. So Ollama pull, the idea of pulling down a container image, but here we're pulling down a local large language model, which is pretty cool, onto our local machine. So what I wanna do is I'm gonna jump into the terminal here. If I type Ollama, I can see that there's a whole bunch of commands that I can go ahead and run. So I've already pulled down a model, so I'm just going to go Ollama list, see the models that are available to me, and there we are. So Phi 3 is available for me, downloaded that 2 months ago. So if I wanted to go ahead and start that model, or run it, sorry, I'm gonna go Ollama run Phi 3. And that's gonna go ahead and start to run. So what I might do, I can actually exit this using by CLS, and I'll get a bit more real estate going there. So if I say, give me 3 bullet points on leg exercises that I can do in the gym. Just press enter. That's gonna go ahead and generate a response back from the model. So it's talking about squats, favorite exercise, and it's gonna go ahead and generate text through the command line. So it's actually responding to us as a local large language model would in any types of different applications. But that's all very well and good doing it through the terminal. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna actually go ahead, stop that, bye, and go into Visual Studio. So this is just a bare bones Visual Studio solution. And all I've done is I've installed a Semantic Kernel. So the Semantic Kernel NuGet package, the latest one there. I haven't really installed anything else. So to actually go ahead and use Ollama within this console application, all I need to do is just var endpoint and create a new URI, which will point to where that local large language, I'm serving the Ollama host, which is on localhost 11434, and then provide a model ID. So this will be the name of the model that we're using, which is Phi 3. Cool. And then from here, we can actually start to build our Semantic Kernel as we would with any other Semantic Kernel application. So var kernel builder, I'm gonna go ahead and build my kernel. If I can actually spell kernel right. create builder. I'm going to have to go ahead and import the using statement for Semantic Kernel. And then from here, I'm going to add OpenAI chat completion. And then I'm going to pass in, so for my model ID, it's going to be the model ID. For the API key, I don't need to provide an API key. I can just use null, because then the endpoint that we're going to use will be the endpoint for our Ollama model. And I just need to go ahead and suppress this. This is a compilation error, but I'm going to go ahead and suppress that. And then once I've got my kernel builder going, I can actually go kernelbuilder.build, which will go ahead and build my kernel for me. Fantastic. So now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to do a bit of copy and pasting, and I'll do this in various steps. So first thing I'm going to do is paste in the prompt. So again, I'm creating an exercise bot. So I'm essentially telling my Semantic Kernel application that this is going to be an exercise bot. Can have a conversation with you about any related fitness topic, give explicit instructions on how to perform exercises, or provide general information about fitness. Or if they don't know an answer to the question, just respond saying, I don't know, and then format the response in this manner. And then using that prompt, I'm going to create that function, kernel function, from the prompt that I've given it. And then I'm just going to add my chat history as a kernel argument. Cool. And then once I've done that, I'm just going to copy and paste this while loop. So again, we're going to say, okay, please ask me a question. And if it's not equal to quit, we're just essentially going to allow the Semantic Kernel to answer questions that the user might have. And in this case, we're not using Azure OpenAI, we're not using OpenAI's API, we're going to be using our local model that is being served through Ollama. So I'm just going to go ahead, build that, make sure that there's nothing wrong with it. Build started. And there we go, it succeeded. So now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and run it. Just expand that a little bit. I thought I was going to get a cup of tea in. And I'm going to say, give me 3 leg exercises in brief bullet point format. Not the greatest question in the world, but whatever. Cool, and there we go. So Semantic Kernel's giving me a response to my question. So give me 3 leg exercises in brief bullet point format. And it's gone ahead and recommended squats, it's recommended lunges, it's recommended deadlifts, which is fantastic. So that's just a quick example about how you can use Ollama to host a large language model on your local machine and use Semantic Kernel to interact and build applications that use that local large, that large language model, excuse me. Cool, so let's move on to our second option. So our second option is to use LM Studio. Now with LM Studio, we can run large language models on our local machine and offline. We can use those models through this in-app chat UI, or we can interact with it using an OpenAI compatible local server. And we can also download and discover large language models through this application. So I can see, I can look for Llama models, Mistral models, by 3, which we'll be using, Falcon, Starcoder, all of these cool names that, you know, I don't know how they come up with these names, but it's still pretty cool. So if I look at my models, I've gone ahead and downloaded by 3 already. I can actually interact with this locally using the AI chat. So if I go ahead and create a new chat and say, give me a 3 chest exercises. Go ahead, and that's going to go ahead and generate a response using the large language model that's hosted locally on LM Studio, which is pretty cool. So rather than working for a terminal, we can use this UI interface through the application, which is pretty neat. I can actually go ahead and start a local server for this. So if I click on local server, I can see that I can expose it to a port that I configure. Obviously, you don't want the same port as you're running Ollama if you're running both at the same time. There's some supported endpoints as well, so chat completions, embeddings. I can view the different models as well. There's also some API documentation, which could be pretty handy if I'm starting to develop with this. So I'm going to go ahead and start that server. And we can see some logs are being emitted here down below, which is pretty cool. And first things first, I'm actually going to try this Hello World curl example. So I can see that it's very squished. Sorry, I'm like compressing my my screen resolution. But essentially what I'm going to do is I'll open up Postman. And I was running this before, but essentially we can, I'll just get some more real estate going here. I can tell the server which model I'm going to use. So that's 5.3, the one I've downloaded before. I can define some system messages, so answering rhymes, and also tell the user to introduce myself. Also set the temperature, the max tokens, and whether it's going to be a streaming response or not. So if I click on set this to true, it's going to stream that response from the large language model. So if I go ahead and send that, now it looks like it's taking its long its time to send its request. But if I open up LM Studio again, I can see the response being streamed through the server logs. So it looks like it's completed. So if I go back into Postman, I can see that it's responded with greetings. My name's a delightful riddle, etc., 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 which is pretty cool. So now how do we actually apply this to Semantic Kernel? Well, it's fairly straightforward. So if I go back into a Visual Studio, at the moment what I'm doing is I'm pointing it to my Ollama server. But all I really need to do here for a very simple Semantic Kernel application, there are other use cases where this might get a little bit more complex, but all I'm gonna do is point that to the port that is LM Studio is currently serving that model on my local machine. That's the only change I need to make. So if I go ahead and run this now, that's going to reopen my terminal. There we go. So if I ask a question, say, give me 3 chest exercises. Now, it may seem like it's taking a long time, but remember, it's streaming the response back to me. And you can actually make configure your application to stream the response to you. So there, the response is being streamed. It's being generated, as you can see, by the server logs. So once that's done, just go back into my terminal. And there we go. So it's given me my response. I can see barbell bench press there, dumbbell flies, and spelt flies a bit interestingly. That's cool. Pretty sure that E's in there. Not sure it's supposed to be in there, but whatever. Okay, that's okay. You know, large language AI can be a little bit temperamental, so it can make mistakes. So don't trust AI fully. And also push-ups as well. There we go. So which is pretty cool. So that's a really quick demonstration on how we can actually use large language models locally with Semantic Kernel applications. So if you're in a situation where you can't access Azure OpenAI and you don't really want to spend your own hard-earned money on the OpenAI's API itself to actually test and build Semantic Kernel applications, we can use these options, Ollama and LM Studio, to download large language models onto our local machine and use Semantic Kernel to interact with those LLMs locally without having to purchase any credits for an API or try to get access to Azure OpenAI. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a like. If you have any questions, please pop them in the comment section below. And as always, if you want to see more content on Semantic Kernel or anything related to Azure, don't forget to subscribe. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day and we will see you all next time.